I think I said, what? More times in VHS 2 than I ever have in that way in my life. VHS 2 is yet another anthology film in which you got a few short stories, and centered around these short stories is another big story in which a person is essentially going into this house, they find this giant VHS tape collection, they start putting them in and they watch them. And as they watch them, we see what they're seeing. And they're basically some short horror thriller films done by various directors in Hollywood. Now, the first VHS film I actually really liked. I was very surprised how much that movie actually frightened me. And despite the fact that I'm not a fan of that shaky cam found footage-like genre, I really enjoyed VHS, and so I was looking forward to VHS 2 and hoping that it wasn't just some quick cash grab, because this is a really quickly made sequel. Obviously, these films probably don't take as long to make as some of the more bigger budget Hollywood films, but I was still very interested to see where VHS 2 was gonna go. Now, I will say this, I don't really think this movie is quite as scary as the first one. I do think, though, that it is way more intense, way more big in regards to some of the things they're able to accomplish. As an overall movie, it feels slightly more complete than the first one did, but I do think that I just enjoyed just how truly on edge the first one made me, because this film has more of a comedy element to it. Because one of the things that I didn't like about the first one was that it did have all of those horror cliche tropes at times, but it wasn't really making fun of that. It seemed like we're trying to still be serious. This film has some cliches and tropes as well, but some of the shorts have a serious sense of humor going on where you can actually laugh along with some of the intensity that you do witness. The first short is about a guy who gets this eye implant to help him see, and then he starts seeing really strange things as he walks around. Another short is about a guy who actually turns into a zombie, and you get a first-person perspective of what a zombie might be doing, which is rather clever. And that one was pretty frickin' intense and had some great, great effects work in there. Now, what many people consider the best one was the short called Safe Haven. These people are investigating a very mysterious religious cult, and stuff goes down. That's all I'll say. There's also one involving aliens, and around all those tapes is a woman and a man actually watching them, and each tape, when it ends, you get to see them take it out, and then they have their little thoughts on it and everything, and creepy things are going on in the background, just like the first one. It really is essentially a copy of the first one, but there really isn't too much else you can do with it. What this movie is really about, and what the first one is really about, is really just talented filmmakers coming together and creating some interesting shorts, and finding a way to string them all together in a very creepy way. And I enjoyed this film on that level. It really did bother me and creep me out, and I was very impressed with a lot of the ingenuity that was behind a lot of this found footage. Because what I usually don't like about found footage is that shaky cam, or that style, to me, is a way to mask poor storytelling. They don't know what else to do, so they'll shake the camera and make you think something's happening. These films aren't like that. These films have genuinely great effects work, and I don't mean like CGI, I mean like great makeup effects, really, really good camera tricks, and I was impressed with a lot of the things they were able to accomplish with these movies. Now, one of the things I said about the first film in my original review was that in regards to that movie, if you're the kind of person who wants to go into a movie and have things explained to you, and have explanations for things, and have things all make sense and wrapped with a perfect little bow, then you were gonna be ticked off when you watched that movie. If you were ticked off when you watched that movie, you're gonna be ticked off with this movie, maybe even more, because there are a lot of things in this movie that are just really creepy, that don't really have an explanation. One of my biggest problems with this movie was the fact that as the girl watches the VHS tapes, then she takes them out, she's like, huh, that was interesting. And she just puts the next one in. Dude, if I found those VHS tapes somewhere and was watching them, I would be flipping out. I would be questioning my sanity. I'd be questioning my existence. And she's just like, oh, that was an interesting tape. No, that was actually probably the freakiest thing you've more than likely ever witnessed. Maybe show a little bit more emotion. But then there was like this whole storyline that the tapes maybe do something to you mentally. So I guess that could maybe cover for that. Possibly. I guess I also didn't like how it's honestly just a complete copy off the original. They really didn't do anything to change the sequencing of this movie. I didn't really expect them to, though, because this is such a small thing. If they make a third one, they might want to change it up a little bit, not have somebody just invading a house and find some tapes and watch them. They might want to change it up a little bit, but I will say that the way the film ended was definitely creepier than the way the first one did. Overall, VHS 2 does what it wants to do, and it does it well, but I do think that this is the start of a possible great horror franchise for our time here, because the 80s had Friday the 13th, Halloween, Freddy, the 90s had Scream, the 2000s had Saw, maybe the 2010s are gonna have the VHS films. I'm gonna give VHS 2 a B. I think it's a fun horror film. It's available right now for download on almost every platform. I personally downloaded it off of the PlayStation 3 store. Thanks as always for watching, guys, and if you like this, you can click right here and get Stuckmanized.